being an asset is very, very critical because everyone needs help in some area. And the good part about this is, yes, while you're working on yourself, while you're educating yourself, and while you're gaining more intellectual knowledge about things you didn't know about, the beautiful part about that is you can have different people from different backgrounds, okay? And they can put their information that they have, okay, that they learned, and maybe it's something you can take away from that to make yourself better, okay? Because the end goal is to be the best version of yourself, okay? You don't have to be a rocket scientist. You don't have to be a full-blown athlete going to the NFL, and you definitely don't have to be the strongest person mentally or emotionally, but you need to have a well-rounded base encompassing all those things, okay, to really put yourself in the best position to make good choices, whether it's life or death, scenarios that you have to use quick thinking, if it's choices involving family, if it's choice involving some emotional attachment and you're not sure what to do, okay, you understand how to go gather your resources, collect the data, analyze it, and then come up with a solution. Okay, so being an asset is more about encompassing all those things to be a productive human being to society, and then also helping those in need. Not that you have to go out helping every single person you see, but, you know, start with your family. There's always something, males and females, whoever, anybody, kids, growing up, whatever, that somebody needs to work on something to some level or varying degree. Okay. And the more assets that we create, okay, the world slowly, incrementally starts to change and turn into a better place because you have to be the change that you want to see, okay? And you have to positively push that out as the agenda, okay, that this is the change that we need. This is the change we are not going in the right direction, okay? So being an asset kind of forms a little bubble and circle around things you should be practicing on a daily basis. People want to protect their family. That's a huge, huge key factor, especially in today and the way the world is going. Defense and survival is a huge thing to take in. First and foremost, even before that, is mentality. Okay? You have to have control over your emotions. You have to have a good mentality on your shoulders to do the right thing. And you have to be able to physically be able to make that choice. And when you go through with the action, whatever it may be, you have to understand that these categories all come into play, not only just with defense and survival, but with daily life choices, the way you communicate with people, the way you present yourself in a crowd or just walking through a store. Being an asset is very critical in those aspects because it defines who you are as an individual, okay? And what you bring to the table, not for me or anyone else, even what you bring to the table for yourself or your family members or loved ones, okay? And then you teach them with those the values and the upholding traditions that say, hey, these are the way that things go, and this is how you act, this is how you counteract with certain proposals and certain things that go on in life. It gives you that baseline understanding that you can also now, if you haven't already, this is for the younger people, to raise the next ones to be just as good, if not better. Because the way we're going about this now, we're not doing that. Okay, so we need to bring this back into the playing field of, hey, you want to create good results with good people and, you know, the way that everyone wants the world to be, but it's not because there's not enough people that believe in that common factor. Okay, well, invite them here. Invite them in this social network that they are surrounded and they communicate with like-minded people. That way you don't feel so out of place, okay? Because when you're focused on being an asset, you're constantly improving or you look to improve something. Even reading books, great educational tool to read books still in today's world, even though you have it all on your phone, that's great, but it's still good to sit back and read. When you go to introduce your kids to something, and you go to see how their emotional and intellectual levels work on varying degrees, and you get the problem solve a little better. People are always trying to find a way to be a better parent, okay? Being an asset is part of that because you need to strengthen these factors within yourself so that then you can then positively press it on to others And they adopt those values. So I just want you guys to get a quick little understanding of what it means to be an asset, how critically important it is, and why I'm pushing it. I have, you know, this is just a standard shirt. I have an active asset shirt that basically encompasses the physical attributes and maintaining a good physical health and wellness condition. So because when you grow older, 90% of doctors are going to recommend you take the platform of some type of physical activity so that you maintain mobility, that you maintain your strength and reduce risk of injury. So that's going to happen. Okay. And it's good for your health because you want to live on to see these things, to see the evolution of the world and how it's growing. Okay, I have Unbreakable. That's more the Unbreakable assets, more for the mentality part of you've built yourself up to a point from all these hardships you've been through, all these troubling times. You've built yourself to a point that nothing else can bother you. Nothing else can break your zone that you have full control over inside your brain, that you will get through this and you will push on to the next challenge. And you can go check out the rest of the line. I'm just giving you a couple examples of how critical it is and why it is what it is today. Okay. And it's, you know, to me, it's new. I haven't seen anyone doing it yet, but this is the agenda that a lot of people can be focused on a specific subject and they master that. Outstanding. What I want to master is, and hopefully you guys would want to master, is just human development, how critically important that is to go about life. And when you're talking to your partner or your friend or whoever the heck it is, more people are pleased with the character and the upbringing and the respect and values that a person has and they walk around with more than other skill sets that can be taught in a week, a day, or a year. Okay? Because that is who they remember. They remember you as the individual and the conversation you had, the way you uphold yourself as a man or a female, the way you direct the message to the other person, the way you analyze data and ask very important related questions. Those things develop you as the character that as you walk about, they say, wow, that is one outstanding male or that is one outstanding female. They would be a great person to work with, a real team player. Whatever. The point is, we all have something we can work on to get one step closer to becoming that. It's not perfect, but you know what? It's a heck of a lot and better of an improvement than you were before. And everybody, literally everyone around you will appreciate that because you stepped up to the plate to do something better. You stepped up to the plate to be better, and you're going to go further than you have before, especially when you have a network of people that are very like-minded to encourage you to go on. Because if you take a notice real quick, that when you surround yourself with those people, you know the saying that you grow with those people. This is the same thing, except you don't have to be hand in hand like that. We created a network that you can voice these things and hopefully someone with the exact education and the background can help give you results without you struggling. So that's how critical it is to be an asset. Hope you guys stay tuned and you get a good overview. If you have any questions, thoughts, comments, concerns, what have you, put it in the comment below or you can submit an email. I'll gladly reply back to you and I'm always accepting suggestions. You know, I'm always looking at constructive criticism, how to improve something, a process, whatever the case it may be. And I take that information, analyze it, and I process the output to be very efficient and effective. So let me know what you guys think. I'm here to help and stay tuned for more.